I'll set you free. And Jesus Christ is the truth. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man comes unto the Father except through me. Jesus Christ is the truth. Muhammad is a lie. Muhammad is a lie. As my brother said a minute ago, he said, Jesus said, if the blind lead the blind, will not both fall into a ditch? Muhammad, if you follow him, you'll end up in the same ditch he went into. You'll end up in hell just like him. Muhammad is in hell, and if you follow him, that's where you'll go. And we don't want you to go there. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And because we love the world, that's exactly what we give. We give Jesus Christ. We give the gospel. We're bold enough to stand against Islam. I'm not afraid of terrorists. I don't care if I get killed in the line of duty serving Jesus Christ, because I know I'm going to heaven. There's no doubt in my mind. There's no doubt in my heart. I'll go to Dearborn, Michigan. I'll go to the Middle East. I'll preach the gospel on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem. I don't care. I will preach the gospel of Jesus Christ because I want you to be my neighbor in heaven. I want you to get saved. I do not want you to go to hell. But if you continue to believe in Muhammad, you continue to believe in this false religion that is based on works and not the truth of Jesus Christ, you will end up in hell. The Bible says, for us to teach every man and warn every man. That's what we're doing. We're here to teach you the way of salvation through Jesus Christ, and we're here to warn you of the consequences if you refuse the mercy of God through Christ. The cross was an act of mercy. Was an act of mercy. There's only one way to pay for your sins, and that's the penalty of death. Either you pay it in hell yourself, or you're going to have Jesus Christ pay for it. I would rather Christ pay for your sins so you don't have to. You're not going to heaven through Muhammad. Muhammad is not the way. Muhammad is not the truth. And you do not get to the Father through Muhammad. And Muhammad is not the life. There is no life in him. You know why it says in the Quran that in the last days they're going to send back Jesus? You know why? Because Jesus can come back from heaven, but nobody gets out of hell. Muhammad is in hell, and he's not coming back. That's why. In the Quran, it says Jesus is coming back. Well, I'm telling you, that's the truth. And Muhammad is staying where he's at because he's in hell, and there's no parole from that prison. Nobody gets out of hell, including Muhammad. He is there, and there he stays. And that's where you go if you follow him. Folks, I'm telling you the truth. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. But you cannot follow a false religion and expect to come out with the truthful result. You cannot do that. Jesus Christ is the only Savior of the world. God chose one way, His way. He is the sovereign King of the universe, and He alone gets to decide how men get saved. And he chose Jesus Christ as the way for men to be saved. He chose a God himself becoming a man so that he could die on the cross to pay for the sins of the world. Folks, if you were a parent and your child was sick and dying and you had the power in you to take that disease out of your child and die in their place, you would do it. But you don't have that power. God did have that power, and he did it with his Son, Jesus Christ. You had sin in you, and Jesus took that sin upon himself, died on the cross in your place so that your sins could be forgiven, so that a way of reconciliation could be made between you and God. There is a separation between you and God. Even the Muslim knows that. Even the Muslim feels the separation between himself and God. This is why he tries to pray 5 times a day. This is why he tries to do all these things to reach out to God. But your arms are too short. Your legs are not tall enough. You cannot reach that high. Only God coming down to you in the person of Jesus Christ. The infinite can reach down to the finite, but the finite cannot reach up to heaven. No man can reach up to God. It took God reaching down to man through Jesus Christ. That's what saves men's souls. That is the sacrifice that was made to pay for your sins. That is it. Muhammad is a lie, and Allah is not God. We know that Allah is not the God of the Bible, because the Quran says Allah has no son, and the Bible says Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Even if both books speak the truth on that subject, that proves that Allah is not the God of the Bible. Allah is not God. He is Satan, and he's deceiving you into believing a liar, a murderer, and a child molester who committed unspeakable evil in the course of his life. He was not a holy man. Jesus Christ, tell me one sin that man ever committed. Show me one sin he ever committed. I can point to sin after sin after sin with Muhammad. You show me one sin Jesus ever committed. There is not one. He died a sinless man to pay for your sins. A spotless lamb of God who came to take away the sins of the world. And that is the only course for your salvation. That is the only course you have. There is